Everyone, so happy you stopped by to see a new video of us. My name is Jani, and if you're new here, welcome. And everyone who is here already for a while, welcome to you too. I hope you all are safe and still healthy in this crazy time. So for a little bit inspiration and a little bit distraction, I am joining today Kat from According to Kat and Casey from Coffee with My Sunshine in their challenge, which is called the three-way challenge you have to use. In my case, I will use, at least if I did understand it correctly, because it is my first time to join them in this challenge. So if I am correct, I'm using paper and Mod Podge, and I use it in three ways in my decor. You see two ways in my DIY and in my Decorate With Me, and I show you at the end my third way. I use my paper print and my Mod Podge, of course. So I had a lot of fun making this, because when you see this, I already made it. So I hope you have a lot of fun. I know I am a little bit long in my video, so I still hope you enjoy it and through the end. So for now, let's start decorating. And of course, before I forget, I will put a link down below for Kat and Casey, their channels. And of course, I will put a link down below with the playlist for all the beautiful creators who are joining Kat and Casey in this challenge. So have a lot of fun watching, everyone. So for now, let's jump into the video. So here you see already, my table is already full of print work, some scissors and some measurements. So here you see my big face. Of course, for who is following us already for a while, he will recognize it. Of course, I bought it in the clearance, and it had already had a lot of colors, but now it has the neutral tone, and I want to give it a little bit of the spring feeling with some tulips, of course. And here you see I need the measurements. They are in Dutch. Now you can see already how we have the measurements in Dutch. So I already have everything standing here for making my, yeah, I don't know how you call it, fenster for this face. So the face will get a little bit of the Mackenzie Child inspired theme. Of course, I have the prints here. And of course, with some cheerful tulips. So let's start our DIY. And after the DIY, we are going to decorate my kitchen corner. So I hope you have fun, and I hope you enjoy seeing how I do this DIY and how I decorate my kitchen. So let's start. So I just let you see what I do. I don't talk a lot of that, and probably you will hear some music when I do this. If you don't like this, just skip forward, like I always say. But if you enjoy, just keep on watching. So here I have my measurements. Of course, I will start with my Mackenzie Child inspired print. Of course, I could have mud podged in the inside of the face or on the outside of the face, but then you cannot use the face anymore, and I still want to use the face. So that's why I choose for print. But first we're gonna cut all the white pieces off. And of course, this is taking a little moment. This one. But you can see in a moment when he is finished, you can see you have a lot of beautiful colors already for the springtime. And because we can go out shopping right now, you still can make your home look like very springy. Or springy, or in ieder geval hier in de Netherlands we say lenteachtig. So it gives you a little bit of the spring feeling. Of course I... This one is a little small piece of white. So we're almost there. I don't know if you still hear me or you are hearing some music right now. Maybe I'm talking just for no one. And that my daughter is doing some music under this or is rewinding it a little bit more faster. So maybe you don't even hear me. here I did two of the same pieces of this print, so you see, and I already did one of them in the bowl, you see, and now I will put the tulips on the print, so it will looks like a little painted print on the inside of my vase, just to give it a little bit of texture in my kitchen corner, so it is a little bit more spring. So I will use this print of the tulips. I also use a similar print in my wooden boxes on my wall, so I only have to cut down the white pieces, of course. Then I will measure it if I want him to be inside of the print. So on both sides, that you can see a little bit of the Mackenzie Child print still. Of course you can use any picture you want. You can do it more farmhouse. You can do it a lot more than you want to. So here you see a little bit what I mean, but I find it still a little bit too big. So I think I print another tulip print out, but then a little bit smaller, because then the picture will be more bright than it will be right now. So first I will print that out. And you see here, I also printed out another printed from the tulips. Of course, you can do any print you want. And of course, I also printed some houses. And if you like houses, these are houses from Amsterdam. So if you like houses, of course, it's still pretty to do houses. And if you like more, a little bit of the fairy tale. And you can do it from fireflies. You can give it a little bit another feeling. If you think this white stripes, it gives a little bit more of a dreamy feeling. But I'm going for the tulip trend, so I will print a little picture out, but a little bit smaller than this one. So I just printed some new prints, because said this one I found a little bit too big. So now I did this two. I did now a black corner on around it, because when I do it on this print, I think it's a little bit nicer that you have a nice nice corner around your picture. I think it looks a little bit nicer than that you just put a picture on it. So we're going to, I will cut them with my scissors, and then I will show you how it looks on my print, because or else you have to wait too long and you get very bored. So I will cut it first. So you see, I just cut them out, and you see it looks a little bit more nice when you have the black corner around it. So this I will glue on my frame, and then I will do it like here in my vase. And then I'll show you how he turned out. So you see how they turn out before I do them in the vase. So that would be a cheap way it is, just to make your own unique piece again, and just do it in a glass vase, and you can do any print you want. I did, of course, this one, but you see there are no limited in what you can do. So I hope it turns out great in my vase. So we will see. So here you see my face. I already have it on my fur in my kitchen counter. But first I want to go do the print in my face. Of course, here you see he's dried up, Now I'm going to try to make a round. Of course, you see, you have to I think he already turned out quite cute, but because I want to finish it off with some greenery, I want to do some greenery in his, around his base. Now I have to see how I get this stuck in my, in the greenery. It just have to be a little bit on the, I'm not going to say wild side, but a little bit loose. So now he will go in the back of my decor. So I will put him a little bit beside my I'm just so perfectionist so that I have to have him completely, so he's already at his place. I don't know if I will. I have, of course, my wooden trees. I have them in several of I don't know if I use first the big one. I don't hope you are really too close to my kitchen counter that you won't see anything. Of course, I will put a little piece under it that so he can't fall forward. It's a very little trick for when you're working with fur. Of course he needs a little bit more than this. I just used some coaster. So he blends in my fur. So now I will put my little cake stand over here, and I just so what mostly happens with me is when I see some decor, I just saw this little wooden houses. I already painted them in the neutral tone, but I found a little piece of my Mackenzie child print, and it just fits if it were made of made for it. So I think I'm going to mod podge his roof, so I will have a Mackenzie child inspired birdhouse. Of course, you can buy it in the store, maybe that's better, but for me, I like it the unique way. So I will mud podge this one first. I will measure it, of course. I think it just needs a little bit more than the And it just needs a little piece on the underside. So you see, you can make with some simple and easy things your own unique pieces, I always say. It's just still a little bit, and really a little bit too big. So now there is just another. Oh, I have the wrong Mod Podge. I'm sorry. So I'm back again. So I'm doing this side. On the house. I hope you can see it, but I think you already know how easy it is just to do a DIY. I have this most of the times, it's some ideas just come up. Now I hope I have the right piece. You see, now you have your own little Mackenzie child, and you can do it, of course, also with flowers, with anything, any pattern you like. You can do your own piece. Now I hope this one is also fitting. It's a little bit shorter. I have to look if I have another one. Of course, I have also a little bit more than and now he needs a little bit like the other one. Just finish up. Really, I have to do it over here. You will see why I did that. The wrong piece. I thought I had the right piece. Don't do it just like me, because that doesn't work. So I will finish it off. So you see already a little bit. I already did carry away a little bit. So you see already I put some decor already in it. And now I will finish it up with some greenery. So first I will do this kind of greenery that gives already such a springy feeling. Of course, I always start here at the back. What's really great about this kind of greenery, it really stucks immediately on your fur, so you don't have to be I will do it around the houses, the little bird houses, and just do it a little bit by my, so the little birds are. Now I will squeeze my tulips in. Of course, I also start at this side. I just pull it under my little cake stand. And I a little bit under my candle, but it's a little bit too much. Now I have to pull it a little bit down. It's just a little bit of modeling. If I just always do a little bit here and a little bit there, and sometimes I change it. You see already now I have a little of the base, of course. Now I will do some couple of pieces of the fern. I will pull some off. Like I said in another video, this is just from IKEA. He is $4.99, and you just can pull every branch on your. So you see a little bit of the bigger part I will do here, just to pull a little bit away of my wire. Of course, a little bigger one also under here. It's a little bit hanging off of my counter. Of course, you can only decorate your counter when you don't use it. We don't ever use it. So for us, it's not a space we have to use. It's just a little piece under here. And of course, some piece over here. And like I said, it's so easy with ferns. It just sticks in your. Now I put some pieces over here because I want to let it come back a little bit more, because maybe I'm a little strange person to decorate, because I always have things are in second most of the time in that you have two of them in pairs. But of course, everyone can do the way they want it to do. I'm a little bit crazy, I think. I will do a little piece over here of the fern. Just to leave a little bit of the plastic of this wooden garland. A couple of berries. And of course this one is also from IKEA, and I also took this one apart. And again, just tuck it in wherever you think it's fitting. Little darker one also over here. You see, from one easy blend of IKEA, you can do a lot of pieces and make a lot of decor. And of course, you use it every time, again and again. Some couple of this green here in the Netherlands we call hedgehog. Some little touches. A couple of here and a couple of here, and of course this one over here, just tuck it in. You see here I did my jars in a video a couple of videos ago. I made my jars for the Easter season, but now already changed them up for the spring season. I just redid them. So you see, you still reuse your decor time and time again. So I think it's enough greenery for me. And now I have to do some couple of touches with a little red, little pink, and a little bit of the dark pink. And then I will show you in close by. So like I promised, I should show you my last three way, but I already counted it. It's already my fourth way I use this printing and mud podging in my decor, because at this season I'm totally into the mud podge and the printing paper. So this is already my painting I made from print and of course mud podge. So this is already my fourth. So now I show you my decor all three ways. Of course, you see my little mason jars. Of course, I made. They are. I did some. This time, I did some flowers. Little pictures on it. So I made this one in also in a video earlier. You can see how exactly I made them. And of course, I will show you first my second one. These are my little birdhouses that I made in the Mackenzie Child theme. And of course, of course, behind my little birdhouses are my big vase I bought from clearance. And you see how, you saw how I made my little vase. Give it a little bit of the spring feeling. So you see, I did three ways, and here's the third one the mason jars. So now I will give you an overview from how I decorate my kitchen counter. Of course, it's not everyone. For someone it's too much, but I love to decorate and give mix and match everything to each other. So here you see two little bunnies. And of course my mason jars. I put a candle on it and the candle holder I painted also in the neutral tones. Of course my lamp and the lamp I also painted in the gray color. Of course my dome. I did some little spools of twine under it and a little paper of Mackenzie gel print. I hope you can see it a little bit because the glass is a little bit blocking the side of it. Of course I did some greenery under it. Here you see my little spring flowers and some two little ducks. I only give them, they were totally white with a little bit of orange, but I give them a little bit of waxing, a furniture wax, so they are a little bit more rustic. So you see, of course, I have everywhere some lights. Here you see two little porcelain cactuses. I bought them in a clearance in a garden center here in the Netherlands. And I think I only paid 50 cents or a euro for it. So they were very cheap. I bought a couple in the darker gray and a couple in the lighter ones. So I use them also in this spring decor. Two little birds. I also painted them too. They were another color. And like you see, I did my birdhouses. You see, one birdhouse had the shape of a heart. I tried to to make it a little bit a little bit round, but it's a little bit a strange round. So I'm sorry. So of course I mud podged them also with printing paper. So you see, it's always a little bit on a budget because not everyone has a lot of money to buy everything they want in a store, and we love to drift shop, so a lot of pieces are clearance, drift shopping or something else. Here you see my boxes, box wood, I think you call it also here in the Netherlands, we call it buxusplant. So I did some light in it, so at the evening it gives such a great cozy feeling, and we need that in the time for now. So of course here you see some nut ball, and of course I painted that also. He had a gold color, and he has been already in the blue color and the gray color, and now he's in the neutral color. Here you see, of course, from the Netherlands, some tulips. My base for my decor is a little bit white, creamy, a little bit pink, and a little bit of red. I'm not totally a red person, but I did this time a touches of red. So, and of course my distressed wooden beads. Of course, now they are, so I call them distressed because they didn't paint it here totally, so I just call it distressed. So I go a little bit backwards so you can see a little overview. I like how it turned out. I love how the feeling it gives at night, and I love my greenery. So
oh,
3-way challenge turned out. I hope you have fun watching how I did my DIYs. I know, like I said in the beginning, I'm of course a little bit long in my videos, so I hope you don't mind, and I hope you don't mind that my English is not that great. I know some people are doesn't matter for some people, but for some people I have a feeling that they do matter, so I'm sorry. I'm from the Netherlands, so my English is not always the greatest, but still bear with me, and I hope you didn't mind. So for here, Casey and Kat, of course, thank you for hosting this great challenge. I hope everyone stays healthy and safe. Take care of yourself and take care of each other. Love from Diane and me, and we hope to see you in another video. And if you like our content, please subscribe to our channel and give it a thumbs up. But for now, take care and take care of each other. Bye, everyone.